I am in one of my favorite cities in the world where I live, St. Petersburg, Florida, and I'm driving around this amazing city to explore the arts and culture scene right here in St. Pete. Arts and culture in St. Pete is extremely diverse. It's filled with everything from theater to music to magic and lots more. Go check out the local scene and get to know some of the local LGBT artists right here in St. Petersburg, Florida.
Hi, I'm Mel. I am a local artist and muralist here in the Tampa Bay region. We are actually in front of one of my favorite murals. It's here at the Hollander Hotel. And then also another favorite of mine is at Coco Med Spa. It's going to be off of 4th Street downtown. I actually did a partnership with New Belgium Brewing Company and the Hollander Hotel to make this mural. So I wanted to really get like the eclectic vintage vibe of the boutique hotel and then also mix it with the very colorful pop art that New Belgium Brewing was using in all of their designs. My favorite theme in my artwork is women. I absolutely love painting women. I'm a lover of women and then I also love to paint them.
I'm here with John Gascott, a popular LGBT artist right here in the Pinellas Arts Village, which is a little bit north of St. Petersburg. And John is a very popular Latin pop artist in the area and very outspoken and people know who you are. So tell me a little about what you love about St. Pete.
What I love most about being an LGBTQ artist in the St. Pete area is the openness, the acceptance and the sense of community. We have a lot of freedom here. We're very fortunate to have many communities that are open to one another and we can have real and honest dialogues and express ourselves freely. Out of 5 murals that I have in downtown St. Pete, the one that I'm most proud of at the moment is the Diversity and Democracy mural, which I was commissioned by the League of Women Voters of the St. Pete area. It's a cast of colorful characters, including drag queens, different genders, different colors, and it is meant to remind people that we are present and we have a voice and we vote, and you're able to insert yourself into that mural where there's a cartoon bubble that says I vote and it says we are St. Pete, and I'm very proud of it.
John, thank you so much for joining me. I appreciate it. You're an incredible artist. You're a gift to St. Petersburg. And it's a pleasure chatting with you right here in your studio where you actually create your art. So
thank you so much for having me. It's a great honor.
Hi, my name is Tom Amadon. I'm an artist at the Arts Exchange in St. Pete. I'm an acrylic painter. I'm pretty much a colorist, and I do a lot with movement in my paintings. I'm originally from a small town in upstate New York, and I moved to St. Pete, first of all, because I love the sky, and I do a lot of sky paintings. And second, it's a very inclusive city, and I love the fact that I could be myself, and not worry about the community surrounding me. It's just a fantastic place to be a gay artist.
So I'm here with Andrea Paulus at the St. Pete Arts Exchange. Thanks so much for having me, Andrea. I appreciate it.
Well, you're welcome. Thanks for being here.
Absolutely. So describe your art. Describe what type of artist you are.
Well, my art is considered pop realism. I like to paint things of current and past cultures. I love vintage things, so I'll paint a lot of vintage toys and games and icons, that kind of thing. So, fun stuff. I've been working the last couple of months on like the piece that you might see behind me or around me are all from a show that I did at Mize Gallery. And what I'm going to do with this show, a spinoff of this show, is trying to promote painting more portraits. I feel it's more inclusive of a person's life instead of just painting, you know, like from here up.
Like,
yeah, it's them. It's just the best. And it's just a phase. Whereas something like this can actually express more about where they worked, things that they love, make them who they are, show us who they are. Here at the Arts Exchange, we have 28 studios, 25 artists of all modalities, and a good gay population. My partner and I were the first married female couple at City Hall. Mm-hmm. So it was nice to be able to do that and to show others we can do that safely. We can live in our community safely. We can work in our community safely. Out. So that's important, because to be who we are, for me, I have to be who I am to be able to create. Otherwise, you're not going to believe it.
Exactly. I think about the neighborhoods around here and how much our community really influences the value of homes and the, right, the neighborhoods and the look of the neighborhood. That's all changing, but I think it's because we come in with an artistic eye. And
The gay community were always the first ones to take a risk. Mm-hmm. You go in and take a dilapidated project and make it something fabulous.
So what can an LGBT tourist expect when they come to St. Pete?
To be embraced, I think more so than a lot of other bigger cities. St. Pete has that big city feel, but it's a smaller city.
Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks for visiting with me, and thanks so much for creating such amazing art and being such a big part of our art scene here in St. Pete.
I appreciate it. Thank you for your time.
Absolutely.
The arts have got a lot of roots in St. Petersburg. There were always artists and writers' balls. The arts go way back in time to 1915, to when the first winter art school opened in the state of Florida. A couple years later, in 1917, the Art Club of St. Petersburg was formed, and that became the first art gallery south of Atlanta. 1922, a Caruso Music Club was founded, today we know as the Florida Orchestra. The Museum of Fine Arts opened here in 1965, which is really the most encyclopedic museum in the southeastern United States. The Dalí Museum opened in 1982, which is one of the first single artist museums really in the world. Whether it's artists, art clubs, performing arts, musical groups, orchestras, you name it, St. Petersburg, from its very inception as a resort city, has very steep history in the arts. In St. Petersburg, there is always something new related to arts and culture. It has permeated every aspect of city life here. The fairgrounds over in the Warehouse Arts District is also new. This is a terrific cultural attraction. It was put together by over 60 artists. There's wonderful Instagrammable moments. It is an incredible facility, and I would strongly recommend people go see that. We have a terrific collection of street art in St. Petersburg as a result of the Shine Mural Festival, which is now in its 7th year. You'll be able to see all sorts of things. We've turned the city into a museum that is open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And you know how much it costs to go visit? Nothing. It is a city where you can get lost, you can explore, you can discover. So it's kind of fun to walk around the corner and not know where you're going, because you're going to find something really cool and interesting from an arts and culture perspective. Arts and culture are everywhere, and it is really a direct result of the LGBT community.
My name is Sumitra Chandratriya. I work with textiles and found objects, and welcome to my studio. For me, being an LGBTQ artist in St. Pete means representing all the queer people of color, because I'm a person of color, and my identity kind of adds value to what I'm saying. And the city itself is so supportive of everyone who makes art, and being an LGBTQ artist is a real treat here as well.
Hi, my name is Brittany Baldwin, and I'm a local singer-songwriter right here in St. Petersburg, Florida. Some of my favorite local places to play are Punky's Bar and Grill. I very much enjoy playing Downtown Gulfport, and I also love playing Pesky Pelican. My vocal style would definitely be big powerhouse vocals. I love to sing, and the bigger and the louder, the better. But I'm most known, if you were to come to one of my solo shows, is for my creative covers. I love to take songs and make them my own, but specifically, I love to take songs that should not be done acoustically and turn them into huge power ballads. I just want me to be you and me like we used to be, baby, but you don't know how to act. I'm Jennifer Real, singer, songwriter in the St. Petersburg and Clearwater area. This is by far one of my favorite places to sing.
You can be amazing, you can turn a phrase into a weapon. speaking up. Nothing's gonna hurt you the way the words do when they sit underneath your skin. Kept on the inside, no sunlight, sometimes a shadow is. But I wonder what would happen if you say what you wanna say and let the words fall out. Honestly, honesty, you'll be brave with what you wanna say and let the words fall out. Honestly, honesty, you'll be brave. Just wanna see you, I just wanna see you. Gotta see you, I wanna see you be brave. I wanna see you, I just gotta see you. Wanna see you, I wanna see you be brave. Everybody's been there, everybody's been stared down by the enemy. Falling from the fear and then disappearing, bow down to the mighty. But don't run, stop holding your tongue. Maybe there's a way out of the cage where you live. Maybe one of these days you can let the light in. Show me. I'll bring you free if I say what you wanna say and let the words fall out. Honestly, honestly, you'll be brave what you want.
If you had to choose two words to describe the St. Pete art scene, what would they be?
Fulfilling and diverse.
Diverse and colorful.
It's very inclusive and energetic.
Diverse and alive.
Awesome.
Talented and diverse.
I would say expansive and welcoming.
Creative and eclectic.